bases loaded and one out.
Baseball and statistics go way back. Almanacs are filled with stories from games over the last 100 plus years. But answering deep questions intuitively has been a giant challenge, like Grand Slam Day.
Going back, that is gone!
The MLB has teamed with Google Cloud to push what's possible with data on and off the field. And I'm on a mission to find out just how they've done it.
Play ball!
His first to a left-hander. And this one to a wide-open space. McCann with a great diving stop, and he hits Peterson for the out! His first play is a first
Thanks
base.
To the data analytics tools in the cloud, answers to burning questions that fans have are within reach now. So in a single game, how many data points are you actually tracking?
In an individual game, we'll capture 25 million unique data points. There are 2,430 regular season games every year, so that creates unique challenges for us as we think about how to deliver that to our customers.
What kind of data is needed to decode the game?
One of the more powerful things that has been done with Major League Baseball is by marrying the data to the video with MLB Film Room. Now we're getting to the point where you're tracking the ball, the players, multiple times every second. You really need to have the right instrumentation and then have the right technologies to help you process that data and answer the types of questions you can get with that data.
There it is! It's a triple play!
What are you using to process that data on the field?
So we actually are using Anthos, which is a deployed Kubernetes inside the ballpark. So we send the data from the ballpark Anthos Kubernetes to our Kubernetes cluster running in Google Cloud. From there, we're able to scale it out and store it in Cloud SQL for our database and read it back into our Stats API. We're able to serve it to millions of fans around the world in real time.
Data and baseball is clearly a beautiful marriage, but I would like to dig deeper and find out what's under the hood. As the ball is moving, can you walk me through the process of collecting the data and processing it?
Now, as soon as the pitch is released, we have 12 Hawkeye cameras around the stadium tracking everything about that pitch. At 30 frames per second, so that includes about 60 more data points about every single pitch. So we have processors collecting all of this data from Hawkeye, pulling it into our data center within the ballpark, and we're able to make these determinations using the raw data. At the end of the season, it amounts to about over 25 terabytes of data. So we can't easily query this data inside the ballpark. So we need a highly scalable technology such as Bigtable to be able to store this fast and read it back out fast in order to get it to our consumer products in real time. Bigtable is awesome to use for things like post-tracking data. So one new exciting project that we're working on is what we're calling Field Vision. This will be a constant stream of post-tracking data throughout the game, visible for a fan on their desktop or their mobile phone. So using our API, we're able to front Bigtable with a scalable technology that we could serve to millions of fans.
How do you process it further to make it available for the broadcasters and the APIs?
Anytime you watch a game, you'll see this live strike zone over the center of home plate. It's imperative that we're able to deliver that information to the broadcast trucks at very low latency. So every night we have a batch job that runs, and we use data flow as a key mechanism to make this work. We're able to move data out of Bigtable, out of Cloud SQL, into GCS buckets, and then from GCS buckets into BigQuery. Once the data lands in BigQuery, we're able to give that to analysts and share that with all 30 of the clubs.
How could teams take advantage of all this data? What does it mean to everyday operations? So how do MLB teams actually use data?
Basically, you're pulling in data from the API for everything from reviewing Major League on-field performance to player acquisitions to running our models.
What do you do with the data?
We're ingesting the data from the various stats API resources that we have available, the regular gumbo feeds, the pose data, and then we're aggregating it and basically filtering it down into actionable information for our personnel.
What are some of the tools that you use to gain the insights?
Not sure I want to answer that one.
Okay. So I'm trying to get John to tell me how his team is using specific StatCast data to get better players and improve performance. But he wasn't willing to spill the tea, competitive advantage and all.
Slider in, fastball in, change up, curveball, partridge in a pear tree.
It makes me wonder, how can analysts use the cloud to help tell the whole story of baseball? And what about announcers? How do they consume this data and translate it to a fan who might not care much about that underlying data?
I say this many times on MLB Now. This is not math class, this is baseball. And it's always about asking the question that you want answered in the ball game. And how you find answers now, frequently, is in the data.
And so when you're looking at this data, what is the type of information you're looking for?
It depends whether I'm looking for an extreme, a specific instance, like a longest career home run or a fastest pitch, or whether I'm looking at something that bans more of a career. That's where I would use any combination of a website, like a Baseball Savant, FanGraphs, a Baseball Reference. StatCast allows us to measure everything on the baseball field. We can tell you how fast a pitch was, how hard a ball was hit. We can tell you how far a home run went. And those are the things that I think can really speak to fans.
Now I get it. A massive amount of data from the field is captured, processed, and published as APIs to power tools like Savant, Film Room, and internal and external research. Data and analytics in the cloud are powerful tools, and it's been amazing learning how it's applied in the sports world today. I am so excited for the future of sports data analytics. Thanks for joining me on this journey.